Hi everyone, welcome to Common Knowledge Sharing Program. In this video, we'll be discussing about the DNS name resolution process. First of all, we need to have a good understanding on the DNS name resolution, how the DNS name is getting resolved when a user is accessing any web application or any network resources. Because in troubleshooting of Active Directory, this DNS understanding plays a major role. So if you have a good understanding how the DNS name resolution works, so it will be easy for us to come through many troubleshooting issues, because we all know that Active Directory is integrated with the DNS. It works on integration with the DNS. So if there is any misconfiguration in DNS, or if the DNS name resolution is not working properly, so definitely this will create a issue in the network access. So that's why I have planned to create this video, so that anyone can understand how the DNS name resolution works. So based on that, they can find where might be the issue. Okay, so we'll start with the video. So in this diagram, I have just mentioned a few servers, like a DNS server, domain controller, application server, web server, and database server, and file server, and few of the clients. So in this video, I'll be explaining you how the name resolution works when a user is accessing a web page or a web application which is there in the intranet. So here I have a web server running with IIS, so that the website name I have mentioned here, it is common.com, www.common.com, and this web server is going to be accessed by the end user through a browser. Usually the communication is going to happen between the web server and the browser, that is the IIS, which is running on the Windows machine, and the client, the browser, it may be a Chrome or any other browsers. So exact communication is going to happen between the IIS and the Chrome browser. So first of all, when we type the URL or the website name or the web application name in the URL and then press enter, what happens? We need to understand this. See, whenever a network access is initiated, see, for any network access, we'll be using a respective application. Example, for accessing a mail, we'll be using MS Outlook or Outlook Express or something like that. When we access any remote desktop connection, Windows computer, when you want to connect a remote desktop connection of a Windows computer, we use remote desktop connection software. If you want to remote desktop, if you want to connect a Linux computer through network, we use a PuTTY. So if you want to access a file server, we use the File Explorer. So obviously for any network communication, we'll be using a client application to access the respective server or service. So the application which we use, that application need to know the destination IP address. Say in this example, I'm using the web browser. So where in the web browser, I'm typing the URL of the web server, that is www.common.com. So but this web browser doesn't know the IP address of the web server. We all know that any packet which is sent in the network, the packet should have the destination IP. So the browser, the web browser should create a packet with the destination address. But this web browser doesn't know the target destination IP address. So initially it cannot start the communication, or it cannot initiate the communication. So whenever we try to access any network resources using the name, so the respective application, so here in this example, I've taken a web browser as the client application. So this web browser application will be trying to get the IP address of the given name. See, in every computer, a service called a DNS client service will be running. It may be a server computer or a desktop computer, or it may be any computer. Every computer will be running with the DNS client service. The work of the DNS client service is to get the name resolved for the required applications. So initially, when you access any network resources or network application using its name, so the application first requests the DNS client service to resolve the name. And also the DNS client service will be maintaining a cache called DNS client cache. In this DNS client cache, it will have the name and IP address information of the computers which has been accessed already from this computer. So assume this is the first time we are trying to access this name www.commo.com from this computer. So definitely this name will not be available in the cache. So there is no other option for the DNS client service. So it has to give the query to the local DNS server, for which the local DNS server should also maintain the DNS resource request, so through which the local DNS server can resolve the name. So whenever a name resolution request is given to the DNS client service from any application, so first the DNS client service will be looking into its cache. If the name is available in the cache, the requested name's IP will be given to the requested application. But in this case, I'm saying that the particular URL is this is the first time you are accessing the URL. So the DNS client cache will not have the requested names or its IP information. So now the DNS client service has to request the local DNS server to resolve the name, for which the DNS client service should know which is the local DNS server. So our DNS client service get to know the local DNS server through the TCP/IP configuration. Usually in the network configuration, the TCP/IP configuration, we used to configure the IP address, subnet mask, and then the gateway, and also we configure the preferred DNS IP. So the preferred DNS IP is the reference for the DNS client service, where this DNS client service picks the IP address from the TCP/IP configuration, so that the DNS client service knows which is the local DNS server. So if the DNS client service doesn't find the requested name in its cache, so immediately the DNS client service will be giving the request to the local DNS server. So the local, once that local DNS server receives the query from the DNS client, immediately the DNS server will be looking in its a database, which we call it as a DNS resource records. So that is the records are maintained in the DNS zone. So in the DNS zone, usually the DNS server will be maintaining all computers name and IP address information. That is the A record, host record. So the local DNS server will be maintaining the host record of all the computers available in the network. So based on the configuration, usually the DNS server can be configured in three modes. One is the all the records should be dynamically updated, or the records should be manually created. When the records should be created dynamically, so where we can have two options. One is any computer which is joined to the domain. So those computers name and IP information will be added into the host records by default. Or else we can go with the other configuration where any device which is connected in the physical network, so that computer's name and IP address will be stored in the DNS servers or host records. So just for the example here, I'm saying that this DNS server is configured to store all the name and IP address of the computers which is joined to the domain. So here this DNS server maintains the DNS resource records. So whenever a name resolution request is given to the DNS server, so it looks into the database, and if the requested name is available in the database, immediately the IP address which is available in the A record, so or the C name record, so the IP address is now given to the requested client service. So that once the DNS client service gets the IP resolved from the DNS server, it updates its DNS client cache, and then the same is given to the requested application. So now the requested application gets the IP address of the requested name. So then the requested application can now communicate with the destination server directly. So this is how the name resolution process works. So in troubleshooting, we need to check in many stages. First of all, when we are trying to access any application from a client machine, so if the if the destination is not accessible, in that case, first what we need to do is we need to try to clear the DNS client cache. So after clearing the DNS client cache, we can try to access the destination using the name, and also we can also manually verify whether the requested name is available in the cache or not. So you can manually clear the cache by using the command ipconfig slash flush DNS, and so through this command the DNS client cache will get cleared, so that the client service, the whenever the name resolution request is given to the DNS client service, so that the DNS client service will request the DNS server to resolve the name. And also from the client system, we can also make sure whether the requested name is getting resolved or not using the nslookup command. So this nslookup, using this nslookup command, we can query whether the required record is available in the DNS server or not. So based on that, we can proceed our troubleshootings. So I hope in this video, through this video, you have understood how the name resolution process works. And in the upcoming videos, I'll be demonstrating you how to configure the DNS server and how to troubleshoot the DNS server, so that it can help you to resolve the issues in your production environment. And that's all the end of this video. And I also request you to subscribe our channel and like the video. And also you can share the same with your friends. Thank you. Bye.